Hello and welcome to lecture 11 in GIT 230. This time we'll talk about drawing tools in Adobe Illustrator. Primary among all the drawing tools in Illustrator is the pen tool. The pen tool has been around for a long time, obviously. It's based on some relatively simple concepts in practice. There's a little bit more complexity behind the scenes. Luckily, we don't have to worry about the math. We'll talk about modifying paths, some different ways of doing that with variations of the pen tool or the pen tool group family, and some alternate drawing methods that allow you to do vector artwork without Bézier curves. So that may appeal to some of you like it does to me. So, quick review, Bézier curve is a mathematical function that allows you to modify the angle and trajectory of a path based on Bézier handles. So as you can see in that animation, the handles and anchor points can be moved independently. Changing the angle of those control points or Bézier points is going to change the degree of curvature on that path. So based on your control point, you can move those handles out further. It's going to give you a more steep or sharper curve. Keep them going in the original direction of the path. It's going to straighten out that curve. So this is simple to experiment with. Just make a simple path with a begin point and an end point, and add some Bézier handles on there and start tweaking it to your heart's content. And you'll see quickly that you can start to make all sorts of different shapes and modify that simple line into all kinds of different curves. It gets much more complex in the different things that you can do as you increase your capability with that tool. So some basic ideas. Simple is better. The fewer points you can get away with, the more neat and tidy your curves are going to be. And the better things are going to scale, it's going to improve with fewer points and simpler curves. So, and the example on top, there are too many points there, more than what's needed. You can get away with just two simple points to create that curve instead of using four different points. The illustration below, I have a link for you to try out where you can download a file and follow along with this in Illustrator. It gives you some tips to trace that word vector there and follow the curves using the fewest number of points possible. There's another link that I'll post for you guys to try out a little game that's going to give you practice with the pen tool without using Illustrator. And it's guided practice, so it comes in handy. And you can progress with your skill and learn different techniques there. The pen tool keyboard shortcut, pretty straightforward there, P, can be modified when you're accessing different modifier keys in conjunction with that. And depending on whether you have an object selected or if you have already highlighted an anchor point, it's going to behave a little bit differently too. So when we are on a path, we have it actively selected and we press the plus or minus key, it's going to change to the add or delete anchor point tools. If you're not selecting any kind of object at all, and you press those, it's going to have a different behavior. So these are specific to whether you're interacting with an object already or not. Convert anchor point tool, same thing. You can click on an anchor point while you've got that and change it from a corner point to a smooth point or whatever you want to do with that. And you can also use it to just click and drag on a path itself and modify that curve. The scissor tool can be accessed. That's going to cut apart paths. So it's going to take a solid line or path and break it in two, adding a new anchor point that you can disconnect and make more complex shapes with that. Join two anchor points is a helpful thing to know how to do. You can select two anchor points and use that keyboard shortcut, Command or Control J, to join those into a single point. So again, previous lecture, we talked about making complex shapes out of simple shapes. This is one of the ways that you go about doing that, is using these simple tools to add and remove anchor points, join anchor points, cut paths in two, and illustrate from scratch with the pen tool. So here are some things for you to practice. I want you guys to pause the video on the screen so you can see these instructions and you can switch back and forth between Illustrator and the video window. Go through and try out each of those 1 through 9 and get familiar with the pen tool. These are just techniques for modifying the behavior with modifier keys like Alt and Shift and so on. Command and Control as you're using these tools to modify those, because really being good at Illustrator, there's lots to it obviously to learn, but understanding the pen tool and being proficient with the pen tool and the keyboard shortcuts and modifier keys is going to speed up your workflow a lot and allow you to do a lot more functional work. So go ahead and pause it. I'll wait. Come back when you're done. Okay, so the preferences for selections and anchors. This is in the preferences menu. So go up in the menu, find the preferences, and look for selection and anchor display. This is kind of helpful to have. The most helpful thing that I think personally, everybody's got their own favorites, but the thing that I really enjoy about this is checking enable rubber band for pen tool. This gives you a preview basically of where your path is going to go before you click with the cursor. Helps you to know where your Bézier handles are going to lead you to and where those anchor points are going to lead you to and preview what kind of curve you're going to get as you're working. I like it. Tolerance setting right now by default is at 3 pixels. You can modify that, and that's how close do you need to be with your cursor, with your click skills and the mouse or touchpad in order to grab a hold of an anchor. If I increase that, that means I can click far away from that point and still get a hold of it. If I decrease that value, then I need to be really hyper accurate with my cursor abilities to grab a hold of an anchor point or make a selection. Some of the rest of these settings in this preferences dialog are self-explanatory. You can always open that up and hover your cursor over those, and it's going to give you a tooltip that kind of gives more information if it's not clear enough to you. All right, here's what I really wanted to tell you about, because I think it's phenomenal, the things that you can do with some of these different tools. One is Adobe Illustrator Draw. So this is a feature of mobile apps. So there are various kinds of mobile apps that can do vector art. Illustrator Draw is a companion app that works well with Photoshop, Illustrator, and Lightroom desktop versions, but it also works with Adobe Comp and Capture, which are two mobile editing programs that you can get with your Creative Cloud license, and they sync with your desktop apps. So these tools allow you to do more traditional painting style work or illustrating. You can use a stylus. If you're on an iPad Pro and you use the Apple Pencil, it's great. You have angular sensitivity, pressure sensitivity, high degree of precision, and on and on. You can do layers, you can do all kinds of effects, change your colors, blend modes, all sorts of things that you would do in Illustrator in a simplified workspace. You have just a lot of fine-tuned control, really appealing to traditional type artists who are more tactile and have hand-eye coordination that I personally lack to be able to draw cool stuff in a more traditional drawing method. What's cool about this, and personally, I really think this is the most impressive feature, is that I can sync it with my desktop apps. So let's say I'm a fantastic artist and drew one of these illustrations that you see over there on the right. I did not, by the way. I don't have that kind of skill with Illustrator or drawing in general. But let's say that I did. I could sync that. I click the button to synchronize it, and it's going to share it with my desktop. It opens up in Illustrator, for example, or Photoshop, or whichever I'm working with. And I've got an Illustrator file, a .ai file, with all the functionality of Illustrator intact. And everything that I drew with my stylus or even just my finger is a vector. So let that sink in for a minute, that you can draw with a pencil and make vector artwork using various brush tips and blend modes and opacities and all kinds of stuff. So pretty cool. Definitely worth trying out. Again, these apps are free to download. And if you have a Creative Cloud subscription, they will sync with your libraries, so you can use them in all your desktop apps and synchronize back and forth. Lastly is the touch workspace I want to hit on really quick. Again, if you're like me and you're a little clunky moving the mouse around and using the cursor, a stylus is a little bit more handy, but there's also the touch workspace. And a lot of you probably have laptops with touch screens or even desktops, or you may be using a graphics tablet like a Wacom tablet that has touch sensitivity, and that works too. You can switch between touch workspaces in not just Illustrator, some other programs too, but specifically to Illustrator, and have a simplified user interface geared around touch interactions with your objects. And I'm not going to go into the functionality here. There's plenty of documentation online, tutorials, videos, and so on. But I'd really like you, if you have access to a touch-enabled device, Microsoft Surface or lots of different laptops will do this. Try it out. Switch to the touch workspace and give it a shot and see some of the things that you can do there. If you don't have access to it to actually try it out yourself, or if you do, I still recommend checking out some of the videos that go through these commands and interactions. A lot of it's intuitive, some of it maybe not so much, and it helps to just see a tutorial walking you through that step.